Hi, I'm Paweł Spychalski, and ever since the DJI goggles appeared on the market, one of the problems many people had with it is that it uses those four antennas over here. And it was only a matter of time before some companies decide that, well, maybe four omnidirectional antennas is not really the best setup, and maybe we could just attach some kind of directional antennas to improve your range, penetration, quality, bitrate, and so on. And today I have iFlight Crystal HD to tell you something about it.
The iFlight Crystal HD antenna comes in the box. I know, from the antenna perspective, the box is really irrelevant. However, it's kinda nice to feel that the company put enough of the effort to make a nice box for your product, and I was really like very positively surprised when I first got the box in my hand. So it's a kinda nice. And inside we of course have the antenna. The antenna comes in quite a few options because you can get it in carbon version, and now I cannot really get it back out from the foam. And there are though graffiti styles colored version that I'm not sure I really like from the view. And the carbon version probably looked just the best. Bear in mind, this is of course not the carbon fiber. This is just some kind of the plastic and injection molded plastic. There is, however, no information about the type of the plastic. Looks ABS-ish, but maybe it's the polyethylene. Maybe, who knows, and in total kinda feels nice in your hands. And the real antennas, two left-hand polarized patch antennas, are in the inside with only the cables and SMA connectors going out. I wanted to take the antennas out of the plastic casing, but turned out that the antennas, the PCB of the antennas itself is probably sonic welded to the case, so this is rather not happening. But from the outside, everything looks more or less like on any other patch antenna. The thing that is left is to install the antenna on your DJI goggles. The installation of the iFlight Crystal HD antenna on your goggles is, well, pretty straightforward, because all you have to do is you have to remove this front plate from your current goggles and just put the replacement antenna over there. To do it, you will need a hex wrench 1.5 millimeter and remove the two screws that are holding the original, well, how to call it, faceplate? I think that's the correct word in case of the DJI goggles, and just leave the also plastic, or maybe it's not even plastic. No, I think it's some kind of the aluminium. This is aluminium, by the way. Definitely feels like the powder coated aluminium. Put the antennas in the space. And now you have to make a decision. Make a decision of, do you want to connect the antennas with the SMA connector to the upper ones or the lower antenna ports? And it's not really that simple, or at least as obvious as you think. If you will take a look at different tests of people testing the directional antennas on the DJI goggles, you might notice that majority of the testers users connect the patch antennas on the bottom, but they still do report that they had a better reception and the longer range when they connected to the upper one. How's that possible? Well, yes, the obvious way to install the antenna is to have them elevated, especially omnidirectional antennas, as much as possible. However, when we take a look at the radiation patterns of the clover leaves, those small stubby antennas we put over here, they rather work as the donut shape. So, if you will install the omnidirectional antennas at the bottom and the patch antennas at the top, you will have still the better reception in front of yourself and on the sides, because this is how the radiation cone of the omnidirectional, well, almost omnidirectional antenna is working, then when you will install this on the top, because then you will have just a slightly different way the coverage. But besides that, it absolutely doesn't matter, and probably in the 99% of the cases you will not even notice the difference. This is why I will be installing the antenna directional crystal HD on the top, because I think that's the better way to do it. Bear in mind, it might be simpler for you if you screw the SMA connectors first to the goggles without yet tightening them down, and then only install the camera itself. So, like that, it's not that simple, because if you have slightly bigger fingers, then it might be slightly complicated. And now, when the antenna is, well, let's say pre-installed, just fit the new cover in place. It's not maybe perfect, but should be working. And here comes the first problem with the design. Look how the cable over here is bent, and you rather should not be having the antenna cable bent that much. So rather try to, well, okay, I think it's as good as it really gets. And that's probably not the healthiest position for the coax cable over here, but since we will not be removing this a lot, probably it should be fine. And then just take the screws and screw the cover in place. Bear in mind, the screws you got together with your goggles are too short, and I just tried to screw them in place but failed. This is why you should be using the screws provided with the antenna, because they are just longer and they actually get into the threaded insert in the goggles. So with the screws from the antenna, you can secure the patch in place. And after doing that, we probably will be able to go to the flying field and test if this thing is really helping a lot with the performance and the reception of the HD goggles. Now it's also a good time to slightly tighten the SMA connectors. Probably you will have to use a flat wrench. So just take the flat 8mm wrench and very delicately tighten the SMA connectors. You definitely do not want to over tighten them, because you might break the SMA port on the goggles. So be very gentle. And that's all. We just installed the iFlight Crystal HD antenna on your DJI goggles. Let's go flying!
And now, after spending some time in the air with the DJI goggles with the iFlight Crystal antenna, it's time for some kind of the summary. Does it work? Yes, it works. How much this improves your flight? That is a good question, because some people previously did some tests with those kind of directional antennas attached to your DJI goggles. And for example, you can take a look at, right now I completely forgot who did the test. Yes, the quality, the bitrate when you are flying farther away from yourself is probably slightly better than the quality of the bitrate, and the quality is better with just the omnidirectional antennas. However, there is a catch. The catch is that if you are thinking that you will fly further and further away with the DJI goggles with having a directional antennas on it, you are Not precisely correct. Why? Because yes, those things, because they are have a more narrow beam of reception, will probably result if you are quite far away and you are facing your quad or an airplane, you will have a higher bit rate than flying with only directional antennas. However, you will not fly to the moon and back, because the DJI system has a maximum distance it can work, and it's around 13 kilometers. You go to the 13 kilometers and then bah, no image. Why? Because there is a bidirectional exchange of data between the air unit and the goggles, and when the time of flight, the speed of the waves is longer than a few microseconds or so, it just shut down because the data does not fit in the time frame it was supposed to go back, and you have a blank screen and you are not able to fly further away. If, however, you are flying this thing with the flippity floppy around the three purples and you are just using this thing on your almost empty field to just have fun with your quad, you will not basically get anything, because the stock antennas will still give you a super nice reception to quite a nice distance. But you will get something when you will probably fly behind some trees or building or something like that, and only when you are facing your quad with your goggles. Because when you are flying on the side of yourself, no, the patch directional antenna is not working at all, it's not giving you any gain, and probably with this configuration you will be better flying with just omnidirectional antenna, and the same applies to the back of your to flying behind you. However, this antenna looks good because you replace the whole plate, it's just not sticking out, and simplifies one thing. You can just unscrew two antennas instead of four antennas to be able to fit the goggles inside the original pouch. For that, yeah, okay, it's a valid argument, and probably if you are really, really, really flying in the dense conditions, you will have a higher bit rate than just working with the omnidirectional antenna. Can I suggest everybody upgrade it to directional antennas, like for example iFlight Crystal HD? Well, no, because probably for the 99% of the cases and the users, the original antennas or just four omnidirectional antennas are all that you really need. If, however, you want to make your goggles look, well, maybe slightly better or something like that, and you want to simplify the process of putting the antenna in the original pouch, then yes, definitely. I will be keeping this one, but not because it offers me a higher range or better reception or the penetration where I'm flying, because I'm just not able to feel that it has a higher bitrate, because everywhere I'm flying over here, the bitrate is basically always at max. Unfortunately, the weather is bloody not good. Well, it's good because we have sun, but it's cold, and I do not really want right now to fly anything further away to test it better, because it's cold and I wish I was home right now, because it's freezing cold and I really could use a long bath, warm bath, hot bath, to make myself feel slightly better. Overall, nice gadget? Yes. Something that you will definitely need for your HD system? No, not rather not. And if you had doubts if you should get it, then probably you should not really get it. And the most reasonable reason for this kind of the antenna and the iFlight Crystal HD in particular is really long range flights up to those 13 kilometers mark. Because after that, no matter how strong and how directional antenna you will put on the goggles, you will not fly any further. That's all for today. Thank you very much for watching, and until the next one. Bye bye.